What is up, guys? Mr. The Reverts here, and the Warzone Battle Royale for Call of Duty is nearly upon us, and I feel like this game is just right there within reach of us. So today, I've compiled every bit of information we know about Warzone Battle Royale. Let's check it out. So first things first, the rumors were that the game is going to be free to play, and I think based off the microtransaction model for Modern Warfare this year, I'd say they're going to be following that same little model and keep the game free to play. Also, if you are trying to see some gameplay, there's like a little training mode for the game that you can find on YouTube, but I warn you because Activision is taking down some of that content, but there still are a few videos you can find if you look hard enough on the YouTube search. So yeah, if you guys want to see some gameplay, go ahead and do that. And also, last thing before we dive into everything, some of the stuff I mentioned, I still don't know completely what it may do, or I interpreted it incorrectly, but I'm gonna try my best, and I think it's kind of fun to speculate and theorize all of this content. So if you have your own input, then please let me know that down below in the comments. So now for the vehicles in the game, there are a total of 5, and as of now, there is an ATV, a helicopter, a cargo truck, there is also an SUV, and then a tactical rover. And as the year goes on, I'm pretty sure they're going to be adding more content in vehicles and stuff like that. So pretty cool stuff there. And then for the kill streaks, we have a cluster strike, a precision airstrike, a UAV, and then a shield turret. And based off of those, if you play Call of Duty, then you pretty much know what every single one of those kill streaks do. There's also a ping system, kind of like Apex Legends, very, very similar for the most part. But you can basically mark anything like an enemy's location, a vehicle, weapons, and the various loot items in the game. Now for the rarities, we have a white for common, a green for uncommon, blue for rare, purple epic, orange legendary, and red, which are the items that can be found for drops, and gold, which is still unknown on its meaning. And now for the rules of Warzone, it says that the green gas you can see in the little teaser video from the season 2 trailer, it's actually called radioactive ash, and again, not gas, but of course, as long as you're inside that gas, then it's gonna take damage, and the purpose of that is to force everybody around the map. Now, I'm not sure how I feel about this, but according to the leaks, if you are down, then you will have a pistol, but if you do happen to kill the enemy into last stand, then you are going to be revived. So it seems like you really got to focus your attention on your down enemies if you are in a close quarters engagement instead of just leaving them. So now you got to worry about that player's team and possibly him killing you while in last stand. But once you are killed, you are going to be sent to the gulag, which is where you can 1v1 another player for the chance to redeploy back into the game. But also apparently you can escape the gulag somehow. I'm not sure how that's going to work, but yeah, so if you do happen to escape that, then of course you can redeploy into the game. And you can also bet on players to win the 1v1 to earn a plunder. For the game modes, there are solos, duos, trios, and squads, and every player is going to start with a base HP of 150 points, and then a fully kitted with armor and everything else is going to give you an additional 150 points, so a grand total of 300. And at the start of the game, there's a jump master, again similar to Apex Legends with a ping system, and you can also call in a helo extract for your plunder, which is like the little cash system in the game that you can use to buy kill streaks and other various items. But now that helo extract you can call in to deposit your plunder into the ATM, and the ATM is kind of like a little bank where you can store all of your plunder in. And there's multiple ATMs spread out around the map, so when depositing your plunder, you do have to be mindful of enemies that are going to be camping on the outside of it. For the respawn mechanics, I've mentioned a few ways you can respawn back into the game from dying, but another way is you can take a teammate's body to a nearby ambulance to revive them or send them to the gulag. There's also defibrillators, but I'm not sure how those are going to work in the game. And then there's also a respawn and self-revive tokens. Now for the perks, there's a lot of them, so please get comfy. So first off, we have armor scavenger, there's also ammo scavenger, and then armorer. There's artesian tastes, there's bounty hunter, deep pocket, EOD, ghost, grenadier, healer, high alert, medic scavenger, plunder scavenger, sleight of hand, sneaky, spotter, stalker, thief, tracker, and then bullet damage. So like I said, there's a lot of them in the game, and I'm not sure if each one is going to have a different rarity item or if they're all going to be the same rarity. And so yeah, those are all the perks in the game. And now moving on to the locations in the game, some of these may ring a bell to you from previous Modern Warfare games. And we have airfield, bank, bookstore, bunker, burger town, coast, dam, dealership, downtown, electronics store, film school, fire station, gas station, gulag, gun store, hills, hospital, layover, maintenance, lumber, monumentum, mountain, overgrown, pharmacy, police station, pool, port, processing center, pub, public bathroom, quarry, radio tower, river, suburbs, storage town, substation, super center, supermarket, Torres, train yard, and then a TV station. So those are all the locations on the large Warzone Battle Royale map. Now for the ammo types, we have 12G, 7.62, 50 cal, 919, and then rockets. And then for some of the weapons that are not in Modern Warfare, we have the Honey Badger, the Glock, the Intervention, and then the Spaz 12. So those are from previous Modern Warfare games, and it'll be cool to see if they do come into Modern Warfare as time goes on, but they are in the Warzone Battle Royale game. There's also different rarities for attachments similar to Apex Legends as well, and then for the equipment, there's a lot of them. So we have the frag, the claymore, the C4, Molotov, Semtex, throwing knives, pop rocket, mine, thermite, flash, concussion, smoke, snapshot grenade, heartbeat sensor, gas, adrenaline, which is like the little stim shot, decoy, EMP, tactical cover, trophy, tactical insert, advanced supply drop, recon drone, bandages, first aid, plunder extract, armor extract, scramble drone, and then radar drone, shield turret, helmet, and then rock. There's also snowballs in the games, but I'm not really too sure if they're going to be able to use that upon release. I think that's just going to be for like Christmas and the holidays and whatnot. So those are all the equipment in the Warzone Battle Royale game. For the drop kits, essentially they are like the create a class. Basically you can grab them out of a supply stash at the start of the game, and you can go over and choose the create a class setup you like. But one thing to note about this is you only get one clip for the weapons, and there is no extra ammo. You actually only have that certain amount of ammo to use in the game. After that, it's done. You are gonna have to go out and loot. And for the default drop kits, there's tank, hunter, demo, and then a medic. And you can also use a drop menu, which will drop an item you select in this menu for your teammate by pressing up on the D-pad. So that's gonna be very, very useful. There's some other little small details about the game that I believe aren't too important, but yeah, essentially that's just what we know so far about Warzone Battle Royale. And what's even more crazy to think about is we've literally just scratched the surface of this game, but still we are definitely on the horizon for finding out more about this battle royale, and even more so very close to it actually being released. The rumor is that there's going to be 200 players, which is a freaking huge map if you think about it. And to me, it seems like these games are going to be going to last a very long time because of the player count plus the various ways to respawn into the game. And yeah guys, this battle royale is just right there. And again, we've only just seen the tip of the iceberg for what Warzone Battle Royale truly is. There's still so much more about this game that we don't know about, and I just got to give a huge props to Infinity Ward, Activision, and the other game developers for, you know, just coming out with a battle royale, because for me, like, I just really don't enjoy Modern Warfare all that much, but definitely this battle royale is gonna make me come back and play the game a little bit more now. But if you ask me, I'd say we're gonna be getting some kind of a teaser or a trailer sometime next week on Tuesday. Some are saying that the game is actually going to be coming out on Tuesday or sometime next week, but I think the game developers are going to want to market it a little bit more before release. And again, I've only scratched the surface of what Warzone Battle Royale truly is. There is still so much more we don't really know about, but we are going to be finding that stuff out very, very soon. So if you guys enjoyed today's video, then please leave a like and a comment down below. Thanks for watching. Love y'all so much. Till next time, I'll see you guys later.
Damn.
That was the last team.
All hostiles eliminated. Come on home. Yeah.